Hi everyone. So in this video, we are going to talk about tuple. Tuple is an alternate to an object to hold multiple values within a single variable. Okay. So we know that we have the object and we put a lot of different things there. Like this is a simple JavaScript object where we define multiple properties. Y is true, X is 40, right? And if we add a TypeScript, we can also create a type in TypeScript, which is holding the different arguments having different types. So tuple is an alternate of that. So how we are doing it is latch tuple one, and we can create a type like here. In this tuple, I'm trying to assign different properties. This is a string. Another property is also a string. So here you see I'm trying to create an object having the different arguments, right? So this is called a tuple. So this is how we are creating a tuple type in TypeScript. So this will be inferred, I mean this will be represented as that this is having a string or a number inside an array. Okay, this is how we will represent it. And what I will do is tuple one, and it is also will represent the index also, right? So tuple one, and I'm trying to assign a number to it. So tuple one, so if you see, tuple one is of type string or number array, right? So you can assign a number also to it. So, but if you can also put a restrictions here that your index should be restricted and value should be fixed based on type. So here I'm creating a tuple 2, and what I'm saying is this tuple 2 should have first as a string, then it should have a string, and then it can have a number. Then I forcefully need to follow that. I can have a string here, then it can be a number, right? Same thing applies to the complex types. Now, in this case, let's just check this and then we will go further. If I'm trying to assign a string to this, now this will be an error, right? Assignable to a type number, because here it was not a strict type tuple. I mean, I'm just seeing a tuple that can be of either string or number, and you can assign a string also to the number index, right? But here I'm saying this is of tuple two of type string, which will have a three arguments only, string, string, number. So index two, you're trying to access the number and you're trying to assign a string. Obviously it's not possible, right? So it will throw an error. Okay. Now let's try to see that in the function. So here I created a function, and here I'm using spread operator. Okay, and this spread operator is of type fixed type, means it will accept number, and it will accept string. Let's put another is a boolean. Okay, and this function is not returning anything, it's a void. Now how you are going to call this function? Think about it. So result, we will call this functions in different way. First let's decide what we can pass here. I created a tuple 4 of fixed type, which can be of string comma string comma boolean. Okay, so string comma boolean. Okay, let's follow the same, because I need to pass this as an argument. So I should have a number, then string, then boolean. Okay, that's perfect. And what it will be, I will have a number, then string, then boolean. Okay, this is the tuple 4. Let's create a tuple 5 in just a little different way. Okay, here I will say that this is of tuple 5, which is of number, string, and boolean. can have a number, string, and boolean of type array. Okay. So you can see this tuple 5, this array 5 or tuple 5, whatever I've created, this will not compile because it is explicitly saying, okay, you have to create me by using the tuple proper syntax, right? Here what I'm saying, okay, this is an kind of an array which is can be having a number, string, and boolean, right? So it will not compile. So if you're calling this function by passing tuple 4, then it is fine. But if you're calling the result function by passing result 5 or tuple 5, then this is already giving us the warning, right? Tuple 5 is not declared correctly. But if it is declared correctly, you can pass, right? See what is the warning here. Arrest parameter must be of type an array. So is it not declaring? So we are creating args argument, runtime argument of type number, string, and boolean. Number, string, and boolean. Okay, and from this function we can extract all these arguments. Like I have a const x1, I can extract that const x1 is of type number, right? Because the first argument is of type number that I can get from args of 0. Same I can get from args1. This will be of type string. Okay, so this is how we can capture the values which are coming here. So args is the spread operator, rest parameter we have used here, which is of type fixed, type number, string, and a boolean. Okay. So this is how we can declare, because rest parameter must be of type an array object, right? And this is what we are creating tuple as an array object.